In the Roman martyrology, there is a saint named Dorothy whose day of birth and early life are not known, but whose martyrdom is significantly recorded. She died in 311 AD, just 2 years before the Edict of Milan was promulgated, the decree which gave freedom and toleration to the practice of Christianity. Dorothy, whose name in Greek means gift of God, was a beautiful girl who, besides being attractive, was a Christian endowed with humility, prudence, kind-heartedness, and wisdom. She lived in Caesarea Cappadocia in Asia Minor and was admired by many. A man named Theophilus fell in love with her and proposed marriage, but Dorothy refused because he was a pagan and challenged him to become a Christian first. But the refusal angered Theophilus and reported her for being a Christian to Fabricius, governor of Caesarea. Soon, some soldiers came to Dorothy's home to arrest her. They almost dragged her and then threw her into a dirty dungeon. The guards left the dungeon laughing, saying that Dorothy will change her mind when she is brought before the governor, and consequently will sacrifice to the idols while giving up her faith. Left alone in the dungeon, Dorothy knelt and prayed to Jesus and the Holy Spirit, asking for help. The Lord gave her great courage and fortitude. The next day, when she faced the governor, she was ridiculed and threatened. "If you do not sacrifice to the idols, you will die." "Be it so. Then, the sooner shall I stand in the presence of Jesus Christ, whom I most desire to behold," was her answer. These words surprised the governor, and instead of ordering to kill her at once, she was brought back to the dungeon. Then, he sent two women, Callista and Cristeta, who earlier were also arrested being Christians, but then gave up their faith after being questioned and imprisoned. The two boldly entered the dungeon and said, "Do you believe all these Catholic foolishness, do you? Come and follow us and all will be well." "Follow you to hell?" responded Dorothy. The two women laughed. "Ha ha ha, there is no hell." They argued strongly, but Dorothy was kind and patient. She prayed to the guardian angels of the two to help them come back to their faith. After a short while, the two women were seen weeping, asking God's forgiveness for having denied him. They asked Dorothy to pray that they will be forgiven. Dorothy assured them of her prayer. The two left shouting that they were Christians and belonged to Jesus Christ. When it was reported to the governor, they were summoned and immediately chained and burned before Dorothy's eyes. Thus, two martyrs died a glorious death through the prayers of Dorothy. Meanwhile, when Theophilus saw Dorothy being led to the torture chamber, he said, "Now you are going to meet Jesus, your bridegroom. Send me some apples and roses from his garden." "I will send you some," Dorothy answered, "and I will wait for you in the garden from which they come." Then the guards dragged her and brought her out to be beheaded. After her death, someone came, who must have been an angel, with a basket with three apples and three roses, and gave them to Theophilus. Amidst sarcasm, Theophilus ate the apples, and with great amusement kept the roses. But Dorothy's prayers were truly powerful. Soon, Theophilus was converted and died a martyr's death. Today, Saint Dorothy is venerated as patron of gardeners, brewers, florists, brides, patroness of Prussia and Pescia, Italy. Her feast day is February 6. Her virtues are humility, prudence, wisdom, fortitude, kindness, and patience. Saint Dorothy, pray that our faith may be stronger in this time of trials and uncertainties.